So my name is Elizabeth, and I'm currently a rising senior at Notre Dame High School, and I decided to make a sip and pump controller, and what it aims to do is grant those that can't use their hands the ability to type. And so this is, oh, right, show you how it works. My motivation behind it was I really wanted to do something that targeted a marginalized population, and people with no hands are often forgotten. And when looking at sip and pump controllers online, the prices range from 20 to a couple thousand, not even joking. And I hope to make something more affordable, and so this is how it works. So I don't know if you guys can see, but I'm blowing into it in Morse code, and on my serial monitor, I spelled out the word T. Okay, so how does this work? So the first part of it that I tackled was the actual hardware aspect of it, and so there are three major components. The first is the sensor, and then the second is the instrumentation amplifier, which amplifies the signal that was sent from the sensor, and then that then connects to the Arduino. This went hand in hand with my greatest challenge, as my sensor didn't really have steady readings, and so that made it really difficult to code with. But after putting it back together, there were more steady readings, and so I was able to create this threshold between 100 and 140 when there was no input, like if you weren't going into it or if you went sipping. And when you blew into it, the values would go past that threshold, and when you sipped, they would go below, and so when it went below, it would be a dot, and when it went above, it would be a dash. And I saved those dots and dashes, and I was able to compare that to an already established list of characters of Morse code. And when a match was found, you would then use the ASCII values, which are letters that automatically correspond with numbers, and I was able to print my letters. So, any questions?
Challenge.
My greatest challenge was probably working with the sensor and trying to figure out how to code because I've never used C before, but luckily I had a lot of help. I believe every instructor helped me out during my time, which is pretty amazing.
So, did you first create a database of those dots and dashes, Morse code, or?
Yeah, so the first thing I did was create an array that I named Morse code, and it basically had the dots and dashes of all the letters, and then I would compare what I blew into the sensor to that array, and if they matched, then you would print the letters. Yeah.
You said you want to make these devices like more affordable. Like for example, for this one, how much?
This is not very expensive at all. I believe it is below $20.
I just want to buy it.
Talk to me later.
Would there be a way to expand this or enhance this if you had an array of like all the common words and then you could somehow so they didn't have to do Morse code for each letter?
I'm not sure because the way Morse code is, it's actual letters that are sent one by one. But if I were looking into further modifications, I would probably want to expand into like creating a sort of mouse that you could control with your mouse so that you could like move the mouse with your mouth.
If you blow and then you accidentally spit into the straw,
what do you mean by
disposable straw?
No,
like if you like blow, but then some saliva goes into the straw, does it ruin the whole thing?
For me personally, I have extra tubing, so that's not an issue. I guess if you did do that, you just have to take it out.
What kind of information are the sensors sending?
Pressure.
So if you accidentally mean like the wrong things, how do you sort of?
That's something that I haven't completely figured out. There's no backspace button in Morse code, and so I wasn't able to really. If you made a mistake, you would probably have to write out oops.
Yes, I'll go like a specific amount of air?
No, so the way I programmed it is when you blow into it, the you'd either have to blow into it or you'd sip, so you'd go like, or. And those would be your two different options for either a dot or a dash, so it's pretty simple. You don't have to blow either super hard or just slightly.
The current similar products that are already available, do they also use Morse code? Or do they use a different technique?
No. I don't
know.
I don't know what they use, but something different.
Could you add your own combination of dots and dashes to represent different like magnetic space?
I guess, yeah. I think there are probably patterns that that don't exist in Morse code, and I could even, for the length of the list that I made, so if I had maybe 5 characters, that would be equal to a basket.
You also had some LEDs and all those stuff.
Oh, that was for my start, for my starter project. I had to burn out all of my LEDs. Another thing that was pretty out, so shout out to Chris.
I was impressed that she managed to kill all of them at the same time.